We're joined today by a very familiar friend of Virginia this morning. JB Bryan is back. She's got some great insights with us today. Well, I've been seeing you, and I know you've been talking with Bill. I'm delighted to talk with you today. And I promise you, JB, this is a term that I've heard of, but really, I will be all ears and ready to learn. You're talking stock splits today. What on earth is this, and what are we doing with it?
Well, of all people I know, you understand stock splits when explained properly. So think of a stock split as having a cake for a birthday party. Okay. So you have a cake for a birthday party. If four people are coming, you can certainly make some big chunks of cake, right?
Yes.
So it's like $100 cake, and you can get four people $25 piece slices of cake. But if four more kids come to the party, then I've got to cut each slice of cake in half so that everybody can have a piece of cake. So that's what really happens with the stock split. Sometimes a stock split is a 4-for-1. Sometimes a stock split is 5-for-1. Sometimes a stock split is only 2-for-1. And we have some really popular names. And it's good that you didn't mention them, because a lot of times people think that if you mention a name on television, that means that it's time to buy that company. But no, a stock split is really a managerial decision, but it is still the same cake. You just, everybody gets a smaller piece of the cake. But holistically, when we look at it from a stock market perspective, the capital, the market capitalization of the company is still the same. So of all the stocks that are held outside, held by public shareholders, if it's $100 million worth of stock out there, after the split, it's still $100 million of stock out there. It just may be two times as many shares. So you just, your quantity has increased, but that does not mean the quality has increased, right?
Well, I want to backpedal a little bit and go back to this cake analogy, because okay. I was with you. $100 birthday cake, right? We're dividing it into four pieces. I've got four more children that show up. If I've done the $100 cake, I might be rethinking things. But anyway, that's another point. But I'm spreading it further. And the way I'm looking at this, as you said, quantity over quality, if I'm getting a smaller piece as an investor, do I feel good about that? Question mark.
You as the investor, when it's talking about a stock split, you have the whole cake. Hmm. It's just, so you're not even sharing it. You know, you have all of the cake. So you have $1,000 or $100 or $100,000 worth of that company. And then the split just changes the quantity, the number of shares, but they still total $100,000 or $100. If you take everybody's piece of cake back together, it's still just that $100 cake.
Is this something as an investor I should be looking for? Is there a certain price point when a company will decide to do this?
I'm glad that you asked that, because that's totally up to the company. But I would say that if you're looking at like $1,000 for your company stock, and in the olden days, you couldn't buy, if you didn't have $1,000, you couldn't buy that company. But now there actually are financial institutions that are selling off fractional shares, but there's still a company can decide that they want to break up or split their stock into smaller units, but they don't really have to nowadays, because people are using mutual funds. They're using institutions that allow them to buy fractional shares. They're also buying through exchange traded funds called ETFs. So most investors are not buying individual shares, really. But the I think of anything, my personal opinion is that the stock splits are a marketing move more than anything else. That you're getting your name in front of investors. You're getting people like Jessica to talk about or think about your company. You know, you see this company on the news and you're like, whoa, Maybe
they must be. They must be doing it right.
Yeah, they must be doing good or something. You know. So it is to the average investor looked at as if that company is doing well. Their stock is so high that they have to split it up. And there is a stock split called a reverse split. Mm-hmm. And there's companies whose stock price has fallen so low that it's from a marketing perspective, it makes them look like they're going out of business. I mean, if you look at historically, there were some major companies during the Great Recession in 2007 and 2008, who their stock price went down to like a dollar a share. Not to mention they could be kicked off the New York Stock Exchange for the price going too low, but also just from a marketing perspective, an investor can become terrified that it's gone down to $1.25. So they do a reverse split to make the price go higher. So
interesting.
Right, it is. I think really from a marketing perspective, it's just a way for a company to keep their name out there in front of investors to make you ask questions, see if this is a good sign. But historically, it depends on what you want to see. You can find research that will show that after a stock split, many companies do move higher, but you have to be careful. You have to make sure that you still think about what are your goals, what is your risk tolerance, you know, and know that there's no guarantee.
And have the trust in a great financial advisor. JB Bryan, you've given us a lot to think about. Going back to the cake analogy, a lot to chew on. Thanks for making time.
Yes, Cindy, thank you. Thank you for the opportunity.
Appreciate it. We'll see you again soon, and we'll be sure to share more information so that you can connect and learn more about JB Bryan on WTBR.com/VTM.